All right, we're here at Tipitina's Music Office Co-op, Shreveport, Louisiana. I'm with Ron Hardy, and Ron and I have always wanted to do a television show together, and yeah. So this is it. This is our television show.
Okay, now what's this topic, Dan? What are we going to talk about today?
Let's talk about the Confederate flag in front of the courthouse.
Yeah, that's one that, you know, actually I've been contemplating that for the last 2 or 3 years. I didn't act on it until recently. I wrote a letter to the Daughters of the Confederacy. And it was like from the children of slavery.
Oh.
Please remove that flag from the place where justice is supposed to be served. I mean, ironically, in front of the courthouse there, you know, you got a flag where justice is supposed to be administered. It doesn't look quite right.
Okay, here's a little backstory on this. Okay, this is a courthouse in downtown Shreveport, Louisiana.
That's right.
Now, The argument of why this Confederate flag is flying at the courthouse is, and why the courthouse can't bring the flag down, is because back in the early teens or something, this land, this property, was given to the Daughters of the Civil War veterans.
Yeah.
And so they're the ones who actually
own that
little piece of property.
Yeah.
There's a statue there. There's a Confederate flag that flies there. And it also signifies that Shreveport, Louisiana, at the end of the Civil War, was actually the capital of the states that seceded. And they were the last one to pull down the flag. And apparently they still the last
it's
one.
Still up. Okay. So, but I said to them, well, no, from the children of slavery, mm-hmm. if you could realize that, first of all, the thing, I mean, I'm going to take the letter out of sequence, but go to the part where, me, I'm scared of the sequel. There's always a sequel. And I asked them, is this a marker for the sequel? Because it's a scary thought for those of us who would have to be on the other side of this sequel.
Right.
So that's one of the points. And the next point is, okay, how could you then, now you live in America, and we want to free the world with democracy and da 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 da. Well, that era represented no freedom and democracy for a certain group of people, which is people that look like me.
Right.
So, now how can you sleep at night when you send your children over to fight these wars to make other people free and think the whole world should be free when, in fact, this is something you actually oppose? And next thing, even if you're, okay, I understand the fact that they were your ancestors, right? Okay, these are your ancestors. But if your ancestors was wrong, you can't keep celebrating them, because all of them are basically, I bet they call themselves good Christians.
Well, let's,
the Confederate.
And if you were to draw a parallel, and if you were to say, supposedly, the courthouse in the town square of Wiesbaden in Germany
had a Nazi flag.
They have
flag
a Nazi flag because
of the heritage.
Their ancestors were
right.
Nazis.
There you go. That's the parallel.
Fought,
yeah. So I mean, they just have to pull it down. I mean, because it just goes on and on and on. And
all right, let me ask you this. Okay, suppose they would agree to say, like, pull the flag down from flying.
Put it in a museum.
In a museum, there you go.
That would be good.
And then what about the statue? Would the statue be cool?
Well, the statue's there. We can leave it.
Yeah.
We can leave it because the flag represents something.
And when it's flying, it represents a living something.
Something, right. The statue, we wouldn't do them like they did. But then again now, what if they start erecting statues of Saddam Hussein again all over Baghdad? Then we would feel offended. So, you know, so maybe they should maybe move that statue somewhere in a place that it may be a little bit better.
More appropriate,
that's right. Because it's a certain, I mean, these people, we're fighting one thing, and I have to appeal to their Christian side, because I know they're all Christians, and I know once they're baptized with the water, they leave their sins behind. They don't continue to celebrate their bad sins. So don't continue to celebrate your ancestors' sins. And then I point out to them in this letter that if they go to their pastor, if they just read their Bible themselves, slavery was okay in the Bible, but for 7 years. After the seventh year, you set the slave free. Or if by the slave's own accord, he could stay with his master. But it was up to the slave, not the slave master. Right. So, I mean, with so many things done wrong, you know, and then they, you know, people always want God to bless America, in which he has blessed this country. Then to continue to get our blessing, we've got to stay within his will. That's in a way, I believe, that's why our social fabric is deteriorating. We're becoming the next Roman Empire, crumbling from within, because we're leaving the very things and principles that made the country great, and that was doing the right thing.
Right. And just purely from a very surface, you know, shallow point of view, it's not very good PR for the city either. You know, so you have all these visitors coming in. You have, like, right now Shreveport is in the enviable position of being the third coast. In other words, we're like the besides Los Angeles and New York, we're one of the number one places in America to come to make your films. So you have all these Hollywood people coming down.
And they're liberals, and they don't believe in that. So. You know, I mean, not just to appease them, you know, but just do the right thing too for ourselves. I mean, you know, from two, the daughters of the Confederacy.
See you later, Fox. Fox Rich is leaving the studio as we speak. So.
Bye, Fox. See you later, though. And good to see you the other day. Okay. But from the daughter of to the daughters of the Confederacy, from the children of slavery, just please take it down. And they'll do it gracefully. You know, I know this has been a big thing going on in this city for ever and ever. I've talked to different Caucasian people who've tried to bring it down, and I've got their blessings. One guy told me, I won't say his name, he said, Ron, I've tried to do that. I was the editor at the paper. I've been trying.
And oh, you mean...
He says, but you got my blessing. And we ended with, well, you guys have been chipping away at this, and maybe somebody else will come along and just hit the right vein, and it'll go away. Because we can build a great city here that, and it is a great city, but we've got to certain little things, and they just got to come down. And the next thing about that flag, anyway, it was a symbol of treason against America. So it should be, you know, actually, and like I told him in the letter, hell, my ancestors lived in under terrorism for 400 years or better, in the terrorism. So this is a symbol of terrorism. All the things that we fight against, you know, that we hate all around the world, and then we sit there and appease it and say it's okay at home. We've got to stop this kind of behavior in order to grow our country and our civilization to the next level. Otherwise, it's going to be a demise. And I've been knowing this all my life. I'm 49 years old. I've known this since I was 10, 11, 12 years old. My first speech I wrote for a contest, and actually I won, was about freedom. And it even involved Lieutenant Callie at the time. Was he free enough to do it, you know, be able to disobey orders? And, you know, I mean, these things, Angela Davis, I mean, so I've been on these issues just because they're there, and I don't know why. And I know one thing, we got to do the right thing, and it doesn't hurt. And whatever my ancestors did was wrong, I can't jump up and down and say it's good. And whatever your ancestors did was wrong, don't jump up and say it's good. Just let it go, and let's all move to the next level.
Well, Ron, this was our first show together. This is Ron. I'm Dan.
Yeah,
and Ron. We're both
Dan.
We're actually
Dan and
both,
Ron, so
musicians.
Mm-hmm. Well, everybody is. That's my next new.
Now, see, I just talked to a woman last night who said she wasn't. Introduce you.
Fill her heart.
Hold on, real quick.
It's beating, right?
Yeah.
The music is beating in her heart. Tell her when that drum stops beating, she's gone. Then she's no longer a musician. As long as that drum is beating in her heart, she's a musician.
I'm going to use that line.
Yeah, yeah. That's I got a show coming up. You, me, and the drum.
All right, and then just for a short plug here, you run a nonprofit called Plays and Playettes.
Uh-huh.
If someone's interested in kind of seeing what you guys are up to over there, is there a website they can visit?
Yeah, they can look at www.playazand.com. playas.org. That's playas.
And amazingly, the graphic has appeared as you were saying that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's up.
Oh yeah.
I don't know how they do that.
Yeah, they make it work. You know, they got some guy up there in the sky. He does all that stuff. We just sit there and talk.
All right. Well, this has been the first installment of the Ron and Dan show. That's
Dan
our
and
time.
Ron show. It's called Ron and Dan show, but it's the Dan and Ron show. It's a circle.
It's all.
It's a circle.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. That's all of our time. Thanks for yours.
All right.